Assalamu alaikum students, I am Sabine Amjad. I am teaching you software testing. In this lecture we will finish our topic, that is taxonomy of bugs. Let's have a look at the outline of our topic. Coding bugs, interface and integration and system bugs, test and test design bugs. So we will cover the rest of the three categories in this lecture. Coding bugs include coding errors, syntax errors, and documentation bugs. Coding errors create other kinds of bugs like typographical issues, misunderstanding of operators or statements. Syntax errors are removed when compiler checks syntax. Syntax errors can be undeclared data that we have already discussed, dangling code. Dangling pointers arise during object destruction. When an object that has an incoming reference is deleted or deallocated without modifying the value of the pointer so that the pointer still points to the memory location of the deallocated memory. So this is the dangling code problem. Then we have initialization problems that we have already discussed. Documentation bugs. Common documentation bugs include spelling error and poor writings. Erroneous comments could lead to incorrect maintenance. Testing techniques cannot eliminate documentation bugs. As you already know that documentation bugs can be identified and removed through inspections and walkthrough techniques. Ninety-nine little bugs in the code take one down, patch it around, and 127 little bugs in the code. When you miss a semicolon in the code and compile the code, the compiler will show bugs in all the next lines of the code. When you place the semicolon and compile the code, a number of other bugs appear. This might have happened to you when you were a beginner in the programming. Now the fifth category of bugs is interface, integration and system bugs. There are total 9 types of interface, integration and system bugs, which include external interfaces, internal interfaces, hardware architecture bugs, operating system bugs, software architecture bugs, control and sequence bugs, resource management bugs, integration bugs, and in the end, system bugs. External interface. These are the means used to communicate with the world, and these include drivers, sensors, input terminals, and communication lines. These bugs can be due to a protocol that may be wrong or incorrectly implemented, invalid timing or synchronization related bugs. In the picture at the top right side, sender sends data, but that is lost. Sender waits for acknowledgement and receiver waits for the data for infinite amount of time. In the picture at the bottom right side, sender sends data, receiver receives it and sends acknowledgement, but that acknowledgement is lost. Sender waits for acknowledgement for infinite amount of time. Then we have sequence assumptions related to external signals. In the picture at the left side, when acknowledgement 0 is sent by the receiver B, it means receiver is ready to receive frame 0. Frame 0 is sent by sender A, but it is lost. When there is timeout and no acknowledgement is received from the next frame, the frame 0 is sent again. In this way, the communication goes on. input and output data in appropriate formats, and then can be issues of unavailability of server. Internal interfaces. Internal interfaces can be negotiated, but it must adapt to the external interfaces. Bugs include protocol design bugs, input-output bugs, wrong calling sequence. Have a look at the picture at the right side. In the main function, the function get_data should be called before display function. Then we have call parameter bugs. Consider the picture on the left side. There are four cases and the function temp is called in each case from the main function. In case 1, no argument is passed while calling the temp function. In case 2, only first argument is passed while calling temp function. In case 4, only second argument is passed while calling the temp function. All these cases are wrong. However, in case 3, both arguments are passed and this is the correct way to call the function. Hardware architecture. A software programmer may not see the hardware layer or architecture. Software bugs originating from hardware architecture are due to misunderstanding of how hardware works. Hardware bugs include paging mechanism ignored or misunderstood. Now, what is paging mechanism? We will have a look at this concept in detail. In operating systems, paging is a storage mechanism used to retrieve processes from the secondary storage into the main memory in the form of pages. We will discuss two concepts. One is process divided into pages and the other memory that is divided into frames. Each process is divided in the form of pages, whereas main memory is divided in the form of frames. One page of the process is to be stored in one of the frames of memory. The pages can be stored at different locations of the memory, but the priority is always to find the contiguous frames. Consider the example in the picture at the right side. The main memory size is 16 KB. And frame size is 1 KB. Therefore, the main memory will be divided into the collection of 16 frames of 1 KB each. There are four processes in the system, that is P1, P2, P3 and P4 of 4 KB each. Each process is divided into pages of 1 KB each, so that one page can be stored in one frame. Initially, all the frames are empty, therefore pages of the processes will get stored in the contiguous way. When P2 and P4 are moved to waiting state after some time, then 8 frames become empty and therefore the other pages can be loaded in that empty place. The process P5 of size 8 KB, that is 8 pages, is waiting inside the ready queue. Given the fact that we have 8 non-contiguous frames available in the memory and paging provides the flexibility of storing the processes at different places. Therefore, we can load the pages of process P5 in the place of P2 and P4. You can see this in the picture on the left side. For example, in hardware architecture, when functionalities of a printer are to be performed, we need to send instructions of a particular job from a desktop or laptops. Similarly, when functionalities of a mobile devices are to be tested, then the calls shall be initiated from the handset. It will result in the following types of bugs: input or output device instruction or operation error, input or output device address error, no compatibility among hardware devices, misunderstood device status code. In the picture, you can see the device status description section in which a code is given, that is code 43. One may misunderstand the reason of this status code. Then data format wrong for device, device protocol error, expecting the device to respond too quickly, waiting too long for a response, assuming that the device is initialized. Assuming that BIOS has checked the hardware for all its input and output components, when you start your PC, it is checked for all its basic components like RAM, ROM, graphic card, hardware drivers, as well as for operating system files. Ignoring hardware fault or error conditions. Then we have operating system bugs. OS bugs are a combination of hardware architecture and interface bugs. These are caused by misunderstanding of hardware architecture and interface by the operating system, not handling of all hardware issues by the operating system. Usually, when a hardware issue is encountered, the operating system shows an error message along with error code. This is due to the proper identification of hardware issues by the operating system. It might be happened that some hardware issues are ignored or not identified by the operating system. So in that case, the bugs can arise. Bugs in the operating system itself and some corrections may leave quirks. Missing device drivers, because of which interface related bugs may crop up. Software architecture bugs. Non-functional requirements may include reliability, efficiency, usability, portability, and maintainability. The bugs can be like failure to support required number of users and concurrent users, slower response time during peak performance, failure to support other languages. These bugs are due to assumption that there are no interrupts. Now we will see what are the interrupts. An interrupt is a signal from a device attached to a computer or from a program within the computer that requires the operating system to stop and figure out what to do next. Then assumption that the code is re-entrant or not re-entrant. Now we will look at the concept of re-entrant or not re-entrant. A function is re-entrant if it can be invoked while already in the process of execution. One function is said to be a re-entrant function if there is a provision to interrupt that function in the course of execution. This type of function is used in different cases like recursions, hardware interrupt handling, etc. Example of re-entrant function. In the example code in the picture, fun2 is a re-entrant function. If an interrupt that pauses its execution and shifts the control to fun1, after the fun1 completes, the control is again transferred to fun2 and it re-enters the execution phase. Then we have bypassing data interlocks or failure to open an interlock. Next concept is data interlocks. If a deadlock occurs because the two processes occur or access the same resources but in a different order, then it is enough to change the order of blocking resources. In principle, if a certain set of resources are blocked in different operations, the same resources should always be blocked first if possible. This advice applies not only to relational databases but generally to any systems in which interlocks occur. Then we have assumption that a call routine is memory resident or not. Now let's see at the concept of routines. Routines are synonymous terms for any sequence of code that is intended to be called and used repeatedly during the execution of a program. And memory resident means requires memory for data storage. Next is assumption that the registers and the memory are initialized. Now we will see at the concept of register. A register stores the memory addresses from which data will be fetched from the CPU or the address to which the data will be sent and stored. Next is local setting of global parameters and global setting of local parameters. Control and sequence bugs. These include failure of execution of events in a required sequence, no activation of any event at the required time, assumption that events occur in a specified sequence, process initiation even when prerequisites are not fulfilled, waiting for an impossible combination of prerequisites, no activation even when prerequisites are satisfied, specifying wrong priority, program state or processing level, missing wrong, redundant or superfluous process steps. In these systems, most of the bugs are related to synchronization. These bugs are hard to find. Resource management problems. Resources include internal resources include memory, buffers, queue blocks, task control blocks, and registers. Task control block is a data structure used by kernels to maintain information about a task. External resources include disks. These bugs are due to unavailability of required resources, wrong resources used. When several resources have similar structure or different kinds of resources are in the same pool, there are chances that wrong resources may be selected. Resources already in use or deadlock, race conditions in getting resources, resources not returned to the right pool, failure to return a resource, resource use forbidden to the caller, unavailability of required server, unavailability of required bandwidth, link failure, and denied access to the server. Integration bugs are detected late in the STLC and cause changes in the several components and hence are very costly. These bugs are due to inconsistencies or incompatibilities between components, error in a method used to directly or indirectly transfer data between components. Some communication methods are data structures. Data structure is a collection of data values, the relationships among them, and the functions or operations that can be applied to the data. Call sequences, registers. A processor register or CPU register is a data holding place that is a part of the computer processor. A register may hold an instruction, a storage address, or any kind of data. Network communication links means which communication link you will use, either LAN, WAN, MAN, or some wireless connection. Which devices like routers, switches, etc. will be used during transmission of packets and protocols, etc. System bugs. System bugs cover all types of bugs, including both functional and non-functional, infrequent but are very costly. Bugs result from the totality of interactions among many components such as programs, data, hardware, and operating system. Some of the system bugs include missing functionality, wrong functionality, extra functionality, failure to meet required performance, failure to handle large volumes of information, failure to handle peak volumes of information, inappropriate documentation, system that is not stable. These bugs are directly related to customer and user satisfaction. Now the last bugs category is test and test design bugs. Test and test design bugs include testing method, testing criteria, and overall testing related bugs. Testing method bugs. Testing method bugs are due to testers have no immunity to bugs. Testing requires code to execute and consequently they can have bugs. Test bugs are not software bugs. Test bugs may be due to faulty test specifications. Test criteria. Test criteria bugs can be due to the following reasons. Criteria by which software behavior is judged is incorrect or impossible. If the criteria is quantitative, such as in case of performance, throughput, or processing delay, the performance can be measured. And there are chances of errors in these mathematical calculations and measures. The more complicated the criteria, the more likely they are to have bugs. Testing or remedies, test debugging. It is all about finding any issues related to test cases, test coverage, and trying to address these issues in order to increase efficiency. Test quality assurance. To monitor and control skills and competency of testers, capability of test-related process, and quality of test design. Test execution automation. Test execution bugs are eliminated by test execution automation tools and not using the manual testing. Tests designed by tester can be recorded in these tools and same can be played back to complete testing in a shorter period of time. Test design automation. Test design is automated like automation of software development. For a given productivity rate, it reduces bug count. These tools are of use in automating test design at code level and also at the system level. You can see the reference of this topic is chapter 2 of the mentioned book. This is the end of the lecture. Take care. Allah Hafiz.